panel, and Van, I feel like you might have a response.
I mean, there's so much wrong, so many wrong things. Okay, so just simple stuff. He says he's so proud that we reduced, under the Clean Air Act, our pollutants by 65%. That's a huge achievement. He's proud of it. But carbon was not counted as a pollutant under the Clean Air Act until halfway through the Obama term. So then Obama moves forward to try to now do what the Clean Air Act says to do, and they stop him, and they say that's terrible. So you're either for the Clean Air Act, which would then mean that, and by the way, your conservative Supreme Court agrees with this, that you have a responsibility to reduce the pollution, or you're against it. They talk against themselves all the time. They're for fracking, which is hurting coal, and they're for coal. And when you have this just word salad of nonsense coming from an EPA administrator who didn't say one word about the environment, that's his job is to be the environmental protection person. There was no protection in that speech. This is part of why I think normal people, you just saw Elon Musk pull out. You cannot deal with this White House because you cannot deal with facts, you cannot deal with science, you cannot deal with economics, you can't deal with jobs, you can't deal with anything but mythology and slogans. And that's where we are.
Stephen Moore?
Where are we now on this issue? I think the problem for the kind of climate change fanaticism on the left, and I think there is a fanaticism, I think most people on the right agree with that, is you're going to have to find solutions to this that don't cost...
Is Exxon fanatical?
Yeah, I think there's a fanaticism. I mean, listen to this stuff about, you know, extinction and the oceans rising by 10 feet. But here's the point.
There have been extinctions.
But look.
That has happened.
Here's my point. You've got to find a way to deal with the climate change issue in a way that doesn't destroy American jobs.
Yes.
And one of the points that Pruitt made that I thought was very effective was that, look, we don't have to speculate about what these regulations will do to the economy. We already saw it. We already saw the effects of the Clean Power Plant Bill, which put tens of thousands of West Virginia coal miners out of their jobs.
That is not true.
Automation is more of a factor in terms of that.
I've spent more time in West Virginia than you have.
Then you wonder why you lost West Virginia and Ohio and Pennsylvania. It's because of that attitude.
No,
these people don't matter.
Let's bring in Gloria for a second.
That's not true.
Hold on a second. Do not tell me that I said that coal miners don't matter. That is not true, and that is not fair. No, hold on a second.
That they're collateral damage.
No.
I've heard that the left says that, that coal miners are collateral damage.
You're talking to me.
Not you, but people in the...
And I have been in West Virginia more than you have.
I've been there many times.
And I've been fighting to get the coal miners their pensions, which the coal companies have been stealing.
And I'm with you on that.
So don't go there with me. But I'm going to tell you this. It is very important for you to recognize that there have been people who have been arguing about American jobs. And there have been people who have been arguing that there can be a just transition, even for the coal miners, because the coal miners, especially in Appalachia, that coal you need to make the wind turbines. It's a complete falsehood that you're putting us against each other. And if you can't make an honest argument, just don't make the argument.
Well, you know, now the president has to deliver. Okay? He said this is about jobs. He talked about growth of, 4%, which is, you know, a good goal, right? But he's got to deliver. He said this would have cost us 6 million jobs, right? And this is going to help the coal miners, and he's going to save the coal miners, and he's going to revive the American economy. I mean, he gave a list at the beginning of his speech about all the work that he has done so far. But now he has set a marker down, and he said, this would have been bad, and I'm going to be this. What I will do will be better. And so he now has to deliver because he has made a change from not only Barack Obama, but Republicans. And I think he's setting
himself
up.
We've already seen a pretty big increase in coal.